Hello, hi everybody, this is Tekla Petridou. It's Friday the 21st of August 2020 and this is our weekly video in English. Today's subject is very interesting and it's a question that we have asked ourselves and our friends many times. He told me or she told me that they love me. He or she said the magic phrase, I love you. What does this really mean? In our culture, Western culture, we pay too much attention in the declaration of love. You can see this by reading literature or listening to popular songs. It is very well embedded in our brain that if a person declares their love for me, for us, this means that we have them. We have them for the rest of our lives. These three words, I love you, get a magical meaning. If he or she says, I love you, this means that we have achieved something very wonderful, that we have locked the deal. But does everybody uses this phrase with the same manner? Everybody who says to their partner or to their romantic partner or to their, I don't know, acquaintance, I love you, mean the same things. What does I love you might mean? I was reading an article about people with personality disorders, and one of the most commonly mentioned personality disorder nowadays is narcissism. People with these kind of disorders, when they say I love you, they really don't mean it the way our culture means it. They might say I love you, but they might mean I love the way I feel when I am with you, which means you love me, you make me feel loved, and I love this feeling. Or I love the way you adore me. I love the way you love me too much. Or, my social status goes up because you are with me. You can find this article on Quora. It's written by a psychologist, author, lecturer. Her name is Eleanor Greenberg. She posted this on Quora like 2 years ago. And the question she answers is, why are narcissists so scared of losing you if they don't actually love you? I said again in a previous video that I do not use the term of narcissism so easily, but I'm reading this article. It says that I love you might mean this is great sex, or I'm about to have an orgasm, don't stop, or I idealize you. Idealization is a mechanism that people who have no healthy way of connecting with other people, undiagnosed people, might get attached to somebody for a short period of time and then they might drop them. I'm attracted to you. Many people confuse attraction, sexual attraction, with romantic love. It is not the same thing. Being attracted to somebody is not the same like loving somebody. Or some people say, I love you, in order to make us love them. Or some people say, I love you, in order to take some benefits from us, like moving in with us, like getting married with us and having a family with us. Like, I tell you that I love you so that you stick around, so that you stay with me, so that you are in my life and I use you the way I wish to use you. Some people say that I love you because they know that they are expected to say I love you at that moment they say it. Or some people say I love you because they like the social image they protract outside. There are so many couples that are so fancy on social media. They are pictures, they are videos, and they look like so hot and perfectly coupled couples that these people might say I love you to each other in order to continue the charade. Dr. Eleanor Greenberg says that there are some things that they do not mean by love you, even if they think they do. These kind of people, who she calls narcissist, or I call undiagnosed. When they say I love you, they don't mean I love you for who you really are, or I love you forever, no matter what happens, or I love who you are, irrespective of whether you serve my needs. This is a very important statement, that love can be very indifferent to if the other person we love is serving our needs. We can love somebody that we cannot have in our lives. This is the most idealistic kind of love, I would say, or the purest form of love. I love you so much that I let you go. I let you go to start your own journey in life or to continue your own journey in life. Even if you don't love me, even if you don't want to be with me, I love you too much to keep you captive. There are couples that met in life at a certain period of time, and the one of them might have felt in love, the other person not, and the person who genuinely loves allow the other person to move on, allow the other person to continue with their life if their choice is not to be with them. So if I really love my partner or my husband, for an example, and he or she wants to end it with me, and I really love them, I really love this person, I really want the best for this person, I will allow them to go away. I will allow them to finish our relationship or our marriage. If you say to somebody, I love you so much, I cannot live without you, but if you want to leave me, I will make your life hell, or I will not allow you to break our relationship up, or I will not allow you to divorce me or have a separation from me, this is not love. This is possessiveness. This is using the word of love in order to abuse it. When you really love somebody, you respect their human freedom. Their freedom to choose whether to be with you or not be with you. This is very vital. In the article, Dr. Eleanor says also that when people say I love you, people with personality disorders, they do not mean I love you unconditionally. And the way I interpret the unconditional love is this. I will love you even if you love me or not. I will try my best for you even if you care about me or not. Altruistic love is a very rare form of love. Not many people can offer this altruistic love, that they can detach themselves from the relationship, even if, for example, I love somebody who is an addict, okay? He or she is an addict. They battle with addiction. I try to make them see their problems. I go with them on rehab. I go with them on therapeutic sessions. And my partner or the person I love does not want to follow treatment. Unconditional love, it doesn't mean I stay there and I become codependent for their addiction. Unconditional love might mean I remove myself from the equation, I walk away, I declare to the person I'm in love with that I love you, I want the best for you, but I cannot stay here with you and watch you disintegrate yourself. Unconditional love doesn't mean I am with you no matter what. Unconditional love doesn't mean you hit me, you mistreat me, you abuse me, and I'm with you because I love you. If you love somebody and that person abuses you, the most loving thing to do is to go away from them. I know that these things, ideas I discuss now might seem very difficult to fathom to most of you, because in our society we are really affected by the narrative of romantic love, which began some hundreds of years ago, And we have been brought up with songs, with stories, with poems, with movies, with any aspirations of love, of romantic love, which make it seem like if I love somebody, I stick with them for the rest of my life. No, this is not love. If you stay with somebody, even if they abuse you, it's not love. It's something else. It's codependency. It's addiction to that hurtful relationship. It's possessiveness, but it's not love. When you really love somebody, you want them to thrive. You want them, you wish for them to have to be the best version of themselves. So if by staying with them, you do not help, you do not serve that purpose, you can do this sacrifice to remove yourself from the equation. And this also goes for the cases that you are in a romantic relationship and your partner cheats on you. And you find out that your partner cheats on you and he or she do not take responsibility for their actions. They do not feel remorse. They do not try to mend the damage, either by going to couples therapy or by I don't know what. And you really love them, you really want to be with them, but you do not allow yourself to serve them being irresponsible or hurtful by staying in that marriage. I strongly believe that it's better not to come to that point so that you have to deal with infidelity, because infidelity can cause a huge trauma in a relationship. I've worked with some cases of people who managed to recover infidelity, but my opinion is that we should do things in advance to prevent infidelity. And for example, if you really love somebody, you can really let them know that I love you, I wish to be with you, but in a healthy relationship. In a monogamic relationship, in a monogamous relationship, is this, if this is what you have decided, because most people fall in love and they want to spend their lives together, just having sex with each other, usually. If this is the arrangement, a monogamic relationship, a monogamous relationship, you need to set your boundaries and say, I really love you, I'd love to be with you, but in a setting as we have agreed upon. I have sex with you, you have sex with me, we don't have sex with other people, we don't cheat on each other, we tell each other everything, we don't keep secrets, we are partners in life, we discuss how we feel, we discuss what we do, etc. In my line of work, being a psychologist and working with couples for over 20 years, and adults, and young adults, I've come too many times in front of the phenomenon that you have one person mourning for the loss of a relationship or mourning for the fidelity, for the loss of the fidelity of their partner, and they keep insisting that they love somebody no matter how they treat them. And they say, I love him so much, I love her so much, I don't care if he cheated on me, I don't care if she cheated on me, I want to be with her, I want to be with him, no matter what. At the point that loving your partner surpasses loving yourself and you lose the boundaries of yourself and you found yourself in a victimized position, in a victimized situation where you accept things that you wouldn't accept under any other circumstances, then you cannot have love for the other person if your self-love is compromised. To be able to love somebody, to really love somebody and do it in a dignified manner, you need to love yourself, first of all. So my suggestion is that it's a good idea to get rid of all these cultural influences about romantic love, to try to establish our own, perception of love. And when we are in a relationship or we flirt with somebody, it's a brilliant idea to discuss with the other person what does love, romantic love, means for us. What does it mean when I say I love you? What does it mean when you say you love me? It's good to agree upon these terms and not listen to those terms and interpret them the way we have it in our brain or the way popular culture has it has it established, without establishing this with our partner. Our partner, our romantic partner, our sex partner should be able to explain to us what I love you means. Ask them, why do you love me? Why? Do you love me because I love you? That's not a good question. That's not a good answer. If somebody loves you because you love them, this might mean that they want you to love them. They want you to offer them whatever your love offers, so they love you for loving them. If they answer, I love you because you are yourself and you are a lovable person, this is a good answer. Please, I hope that some people do not copy these answers from this video. Or if somebody says, I love you because all my friends and family have a very good opinion about you, and by loving you, I will have a very good family, this is also not a good answer, because it means that they love the idea of being with you, not you per se. I love you means I like you as a person too much. I want you to be happy no matter what, even if you are with me or not. And I will still love you if you hurt me or if you abuse me, but I will not allow you to continue to do so. Real love means forgiving the other person for their misdemeanors or their mistakes. But if we are not safe emotionally, psychologically, physically around them, we do not stay around them. Loving somebody doesn't mean to accept any kind of behavior. To accept any kind of taking advantage of us. Loving somebody, according to my opinion, as a psychologist and as a current author of a book about romantic love, I haven't finished my book yet. It will be finished in a couple of months and it will be first published in Greek, and I hope that in the future will be also translated in English. My take on love is that I want you to be happy. I want you to be well. I have warm feelings for you. I love you to be happy, even if this is with me in my life or not with me. Loving somebody unconditionally doesn't mean that we possess them, that they are our possessions. And it doesn't mean that we allow them to have any kind of mistreating behavior towards us, because if you cannot love yourself, then you cannot love in a healthy manner any other person. And even Jesus Christ said that on the Bible, love thy neighbor as yourself. Love your neighbor as you love yourself, which self-love is a prerequisite for other people's love. I would love to read your opinions on what I love you means in the comment section below. Thank you for watching this Friday as well. See you next week. Bye.